So today on the bench I have a Juno 106. It's one I had in a wee while ago there to sort out a bit of a distortion on the chorus. So one of the voices was a wee bit strange on this. So what we're going to do today is look at all the voices and replace the socketed voices with sockets so that voice chips can be checked and moved around and that kind of thing. So I'm basically going to desolder the original Juno 106 voices and put in a socket, and then put them back in again for the customer. So quite a simple video in many ways, but it's just time consuming and delicate work. So just before I start, I always like to make sure the machine works okay. So everything does seem fine and the output's okay. So we have the sides off the 106. It's just a matter of taking them off with 5 screws per side. And then it's a matter of just lifting the top off, or top up, like so. So on the left you can see the voice chips here. There's 6 of them. So what I intend to do is carefully desolder these, put in the sockets, and then replace them in the same order that they were in. So let's start by removing the connectors. And now some screws. Regarding the sockets, I've decided to use decent turn pin IC sockets and just cut them in half and then double them up so that it'll cover all the pins. I tried using these 2.54 kind of, you know, Arduino headers, but they're not very good because they're not deep enough, or at least the pins aren't long enough to go right down into the socket, so they're a bit wobbly, would fall out with this, whereas this is quite solid, so I think it's going to be a better job. So effectively that's what we have there. So here we have the board removed, and effectively what I'm going to do is take out these ICs and then socket them like this. So this is just cut down IC socket, and it gives a really good feel to it, but they're not impossible to remove if you have to. So they're not loose, but they're not too tight as well. As Goldilocks would say, just right. The main difficulty with doing something like this is taking care. These boards are double-sided and the tracks are quite fine. Not the finest I've seen, but certainly fine. So when you're desoldering something like this, you have to be careful that you don't lift all these tracks up. You need a good hot iron and desolder braid. I use Chemtronic because it's just light years ahead of anything else that I've tried. Or a good electronic desolder gun or manual desolder gun. The electronic one is good because it gives consistent results, but you have to make sure it's cleaned and the tips are good. Otherwise it can actually cut into the board and damage it more than you want. So yeah, something to be careful of. So I'm just going to start that now. So the trick with desoldering with this is just to touch it on, hold it for a second, and then gradually move it around gently, and you should get a nice clean hole. Don't keep it on too long, and don't be very forceful, and it should lift the solder out okay. Now you can move the pin around with the soldering iron then, just to make sure everything's free before removing the chip, so that the top bass tracks aren't lifted off. So what you then want to ensure is that all the pins wiggle freely and there's no adhesion to the side of the solder hole, so that the chip will be removed very easily. Well, it's just a matter of, you know, then really lifting it out like so. I like to ensure that the socket holes are really, really clean. These look pretty good, but you can touch an iron over them, soldering iron, just to, you know, help clear out the socket holes there. So I'm just about to put in the IC sockets. Because there's actually not a hole for each of these pins, I need to just snip one of these legs here, because there's actually like a hole blank and then holes continuing down on the circuit board, so that'll just keep that right. There we go, there's one socket just placed in. I just have to solder it. Now this is fiddly work, time consuming, but it's not hard, but there is a potential to screw things up, as I say, with desoldering and whatever. So I'm also just going to clean these up a little bit, the pins here, so that they go into the sockets nicely. And you can just use a sharp knife just to scrape off any excess solder, or go along with the soldering iron and just lightly dress and take the solder away a little bit. So here we have the socketed chip. It just sits a bit higher than the others and it seems quite a good fit. And that's the other side of the soldering that I've done, if you can see there without the light. So what I might do is actually just test this just before I do them all, just to make sure this is working okay. I'm sure it will be, but you know, I want to check proof of concept here before I go ahead and do more. I've just taken the board out of the synth again and it was working fine there. There's a tiny crackle on one of the voices occasionally. I think that was the problem with this synth actually, and that's maybe why the owner wants to experiment with changing these voice chips about. So I'm just going to make sure that all the sockets I put in are tip top and under the same standard that number one is done here. So it's just going to take a bit of time. I mightn't film all this because it's sort of just the same as before. So halfway through the job, my trusty desolder gun decided to pack up. So it has been a bit dodgy before and I glued it and taped it, but it gets so hot that this bit, the element, kind of separates from the body. And there's no real screws going through or anything, it's very badly designed. So these guns last about, you know, 8 months with heavy use. So I'm gonna have to take it apart and see if I can fix it, and if not, get a new gun. So my trusty desolder gun was foobar, and no matter how many times I tried to fix it, it just like disintegrated. So I have another one here, which I had to buy, so that's grand. So we're ready to go on and complete the job. So as I said earlier, this is not difficult, but just fiddly, like, you know, putting in the likes of this, it's just a bit fiddly. Get things straight, you know, and make a good job of it. So this is how I stop the sockets falling out when I turn the board over. Just take a bit of blue tack over it and hold it. I don't push it really hard in the socket because I don't want the blue tack heating up and going into the socket holes, obviously. But very ghetto, but works an absolute treat. So after reassembling it, I haven't screwed it up yet, but after I put the board in, checked everything, I'm happy to announce it. All the voices work, which is great. So one of these voices I think potentially has a crackle or something in it. So I think the customer's gonna have a look at that and maybe replace the voices. And I just wanted to get them socketed so that's easy for someone then to experiment with the voices, maybe swap them out for, you know, some analog or Renaissance ones or something, or, you know, swap out maybe a known good in there. I'm sure a lot of you folk out there will be able to do something like that, you know, if you've got the skills of soldering. It's, as I said, it's not hard, just take your time. So I hope you've enjoyed this short mind burner video, and if you like this kind of thing, check back for more, and I'll see you next time.